I was thinking I might make a video of this anyway. The reason I'm replacing this distributor is after I got the replacement parts. I've done lots of points replacements and condenser replacements before. But the plate on which I'll take the rotor off. The plate on which the points and the condenser are mounted just like moves right around in the breeze. Like, look at the condenser like flopping around. It's crazy. I don't see how, like, the point's still open. You can see that. Maybe you can't. The point's still open and closed, but I don't see how this wiggle room is conducive to good timing. I'm saying I can just move that around wherever the hell I want. Now, maybe under operation, maybe it seems to settle down there, but there's nothing really stopping it from being really shitty. So, once I saw that, I didn't really want to try and operate this again. You know, in case it was something I did or whatever, but I took that plate out. There's no screws holding it to the base. There's no nothing. Like I say, I'll probably do a little video on that alone because that's what led to all this crap. The real problem with why I lost spark wasn't this really at all. It was the center connector in the cap that brings the coil in was completely worn right down. It wasn't making connection anymore. But it was trying to find a cap that would fit this that led me down the path of having to get a whole replacement. So it wasn't that it was hard to find the part, it was hard to find the right part. Because this has been replaced at one point. This isn't a Chrysler one. In addition to everything I just noticed, look, the condenser is actually rattling right against the cam there. Like, that's ridiculous. It's a wonder I didn't hear that while it was running.